Mark Sisson is the picture of health. At the age of 60, yes, 60, he has the body of a man half his age, inside and out. No disease, no medications. But he hasn't always been this way. His anti-inflammatory diet changed everything.
Most of what ails people today could be, if not cured, substantially mitigated with a few lifestyle corrections, first and foremost being diet.
Mark follows the Paleo diet.
If you've heard of the Paleo diet but aren't really sure what it is, you're not alone. It was the number one search diet on Google last year.
For the last 25 years, Mark has analyzed nutrition research. 2.5 million readers follow Mark's work.
We've got hundreds of thousands of user experiences on my site, on Mark's Daily Apple, of people who've embraced this program, who've said, so not only did I lose the weight, but my blood work improved, and my energy levels improved.
The Paleo diet involves avoiding sugar, wheat, trans or omega-6 fats, and some dairy.
When you get rid of all those bad guys, you decrease inflammation, and you improve your body's ability to burn fat.
Sugar weakens your immune system and causes insulin problems. Wheat treats your body much the same way. Mark didn't even realize wheat caused him problems until he stopped eating it.
My IBS went away. My arthritis went away. The lingering sinus issues that I had went away. The heartburn that I used to have infrequently, but enough to be to have me carrying Pepsid AC in my wallet, that went away.
Highly inflammatory trans fats and omega-6 fats are found in many packaged foods and oils that line the grocery store shelves.
And we eliminate these industrial oils, what we call these the vegetable oils that we thought 2 decades ago were so healthy for us. Turns out they're very unhealthy for us.
Many dairy products cause inflammation, allergies, and stomach problems.
So if you give up sugar, gluten, trans fats, omega-6 fats, and dairy, you may be wondering what's left to eat.
Turns out a lot.
Certainly use plants, vegetables, as the main basis of the paleo eating strategy, and then great sources of protein, so meat and fish, fowl, eggs, and so on, and then healthy fats.
Healthy fats include avocados, nuts, olive oil, fish oil, and don't forget coconut oil, even though it's a saturated fat. In fact, some health experts don't believe saturated fats like beef, pork, and eggs should still be viewed as bad guys when it comes to our diet.
Some doctors still have a real issue with saturated fat because they're relying on a 20-year-old studies that were faulty to begin with, and they haven't done the research, and they haven't stayed current with dietary research. But there are thousands of doctors now who have completely shifted and are embracing this concept.
That includes Duke University's Dr. Eric Westman, who used to think saturated fat caused heart disease. Then he changed his mind.
Saturated fat, the fat that we've been taught not to eat, raises your good cholesterol best of all the food you can eat.
Of course, any diet is best combined with exercise. Looking at Mark, you might think he lives at the gym, but the truth is he barely breaks a sweat. He recommends slow movement, like walking, and a lot of it, outside or even at a treadmill desk. Twice a week, he recommends muscle building. Using his own weight as resistance, Mark does push-ups, squats, lunges, and sit-ups.
The tension of the muscle on the bone, it creates bone density, for instance. And we want to have strong bones as we get older.
Then once a week, a set of sprints, giving all you've got for 30-second surges of aerobic activity, like running, biking, or swimming.
That little burst of activity can have such dramatic effects on all aspects of your health. And for people who have been trying to lose weight, for instance, and are plateaued or stalled, that sprint workout can be sort of the breakthrough.
Finally, get enough sleep, because without it, your immune system suffers and you increase hormones that make you hungry.
A lot of people will get the diet right, for instance. They'll start to dial in the diet, but because they enjoy they're too tempted by the nighttime activities and they don't get enough sleep, they wonder why they're not losing that last 15 or 20 pounds. It may be because you're not getting enough sleep.
So an anti-inflammatory diet is missing sugar, wheat, processed oils, and most dairy. So you eat foods that keep you thin and healthy well into your golden years. Lori Johnson, CBN News.